嗨，大家好，我是 May， 欢迎来到我的 YouTube channel。今天呢，很荣幸又邀请到 Matt。
有。
In my video, I don't know why you're in my video so many times。
很酷啊。
You're cool。
对啊。
大家同意吗 ？Okay, so 今天呢，我们要谈论什么呢？我希望在新的一年可以教大家怎么样设计自己的课表 ，because I found that there are more and more people getting very interested in fitness, but they don't know how to design their workout plan because different people have their needs and their goals, right? And a lot of them cannot afford the expense to hire a personal trainer. So Matt found that people need this.Because nowadays, no one really write down.
Nobody writes anything down.
Yeah, no one really write down. And 1 month ago, you gave me the Fitbit, and I was so skeptical because I'm like one of the people that I train hard, but I never really write it down. Mm. And you think it's a problem.
It's a huge problem because if you don't write it down, you can't make progress, right?
I think this is great. There should be more people.To know this stuff and started to use this stuff, especially in the new year, right?
For sure.
Okay, so today I prepared 10 questions for you to help people to know how to design your workout plan, and then Matt will introduce you guys how to use the Fitbit. The first one is how to set a goal.
So, first you gotta decide what you wanna do, right? The most important thing is to set a goal, is to set a goal that you wanna achieve. And if you go and looking around at other people,And trying to set your goal like them, especially if you're watching them on videos or something like that. Ideally, these people aren't doing what you're seeing. So it's a little bit wrong to try to think, I want to look like her, so I'm going to do what she does. She's probably not doing that. Mm. So you have to think about what's your goal and why.
I totally agree, because a lot of times we just see what others are doing and we will be like, oh, I want to copy them, or I want to just be like them. And people don't really figure out what they really want. And what kind of people they wanted to be.
Exactly.
Right? Mm. Okay, the second question, how to customize own fitness program for beginners, intermediate level, or advanced lifters?
So an advanced lifter will know what they're doing anyway, hopefully, right? As a beginner, firstly, don't make it too complicated. Because as a beginner, whatever you do, it's going to work as long as you make progress. So you can put 4 or 5 exercises in there,and you're pretty much good to go.
Would you recommend the beginners to do a full body workout or a split workout? Because a lot of people have those kind of questions.
Yeah.
Can you make a more specific example of how to train like 2-3 times a week and what to do for each day?
So like for a beginner, 2 times a week should be absolutely fine. I know you want to probably do more. 2 times a week to 3 times a week is fine.
Mm.
I would do full body if you're doing 2 times a week.
Yeah.
And maybe think about splitting on the third one. Maybe. Mm. But full body for beginners is the way to go.
Yeah. I really wanted to give advice to those beginners that pick some main exercises, like what you said, like a squat, deadlift, lunge for the lower body workout, and some like shoulder press or single row for focusing on the...compound exercises.
That's it.
I think that's the way to go.
If you actually want to see some results, the worst thing you can do is change your program too often, right? But I mean, a lot of people say, oh, you need to change your program to shock your muscles. That's fucking bullshit to start with, right? What they mean by that is you need to change something. Add some weight, add some reps, add some sets. Make that movement harder. But as a beginner, the last thing you want to do is every week or every 2 weeks say, oh, it doesn't work.I'm going to change my workout. You can't do it. Otherwise, you're just going to go in a circle and you're not going to see any results.
Beginners, you suggest 2 to 3 times a week and like full body workout.
Full body workout.
Full body workout.
Don't change your workout.
Don't change your workout. And then for the more intermediate level or advanced people?
For more intermediate and advanced, they'll have a better idea about what they want to achieve exactly, you know? Do I need bigger butt? Do I need to work on my chest? And then you design your workout.Based on that. So maybe if you want a bigger chest, like remember we did a chest workout, you want to get stronger, we did chest, how many days a week? Four?
At least three times.
3 or 4 times a week, right? Because our goal was chest.
Yeah.
Some people will say, oh, what about the other muscles? We did one day to keep it there, right?
Yeah.
You have to focus on your goal.
I often add the main group exercises with a small group exercises, like the back and bicep, I will do that together. Yeah. And sometimes I do legs workout, but at the end of my workout, I also do some chest or some shoulders.
That's the way to do it.
Yeah, because I feel like for my lower body, I have to train at least 2 times a week. And if I have a certain goal, like to train pull-ups or do the bench press challenge, and I will do that like 3 times a week, and I will maintain for 2 months. And then I can really see my goal is like getting there.
Yeah.
So this is our advice for you guys. The third one, yeah, I think we talked about that on the last one. Recommend a split workout routine or full body routine. The fourth question, list out top 5 movements everyone should do for building strength and look good.
Begin, Emma.
In general.
Okay, so split squat or single leg exercise, right? Split squat lunge. Some sort of deadlift, hinge, some sort of squat. Do a vertical press, that kind of press. That's 5. But you also do back exercises. Remember your back exercises, pulling this way, pulling this way, pulling this way. So any exercise that does all those kind of movements.
Next question about reps and weights.
Right. What do you want to know about them?
I think most of the time I just tell myself that I have to do 3 to 4 sets for each movement. And what I learned is for 4 reps to 6 reps is for strength, like muscle building. How to say? 那个爆发力, like, how to say? Fast.
Power.
Yeah, power lifting. Okay. It's 4 to 6 reps. And the next level is 8 to 12 or 8 to 15 reps. It's more for muscle hypertrophy.
Hypertrophy.
Say that again.
Hypertrophy.
What?
This is how you say it. Hypertrophy.
Hypertrophy. Okay, now we're learning English. And the next level is 15 reps, and above 20 reps is endurance, right?
So, this is again the old school way of putting it. But actually, you can build muscle on any of these rep range. Yeah, as long as you go close to failure on each one, you will build muscle. And for more advanced people, you want to try and do each one of these, because actually, if you do 20 reps like this and shit in fast, you might get like heart rate up, but it's not going to help you. But if you do 12, even 20 good reps like this, you're still going to grow muscle.
They say 20 reps and you are not doing full, and I can picture some guys in the gym and they'll be like, and I was like, what is that? Yeah, but I totally agree with you, because sometimes I do like quite hardcore weightlifting, like heavy weight deadlifts or squats. But sometimes I also do some high reps thing, like only using resistance band. And sometimes I found that the intensity can also be high, right?
If you go close to failure, it's a good idea. I prefer lower reps, 6 to 8 range. For me, I think that 8 reps is like optimal, but not right at the beginning. At the beginning, you've got to do it lightweight. Make sure you can get the endurance up a little bit so you can push those 8 out. 8's my favorite rep range, personally.
So I say that beginners should start from high reps range and then progress to the 8 reps range, like what you said, right? Next one, list out the common mistakes people will do while setting goals or training and why people fail.
Mistake would probably be you set an unrealistic goal and then it's too hard and you give up. Or it's too hard and it doesn't work so fast as you want it to, so you change it to something else. And then to someone else, and then nothing works. As you say, you'll say, I've tried everything, nothing works. It's because you weren't consistent enough with it. Right. That would be number one. Number two, I'd say, is changing programs. You have to keep your program, because it takes a month, maybe more, for your body to kind of get used to the exercise. And it takes maybe another month for your body to actually get strong for the exercise. So the way to do it is to change something, right? Range of motion, how fast you're doing. Adding more weight, that's a big one, right? Adding another rep, maybe even adding another set, or making the workout more difficult, you know? That's the change. Most people, they do a workout for a bit, and then they change it. you're not going to find any progress. I don't care anybody else says to you, oh, you're wrong, blah, 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 my coach said this bullshit. You're not going to make progress otherwise.
I think we're getting to a point that nowadays people just want things fast. They don't know that there are a lot of things takes time, like building muscles take years, but they want things fast. They want things show up in just 1 or 2 weeks.
Exactly. Mm.
So I would suggest that people should take it as a lifestyle thing, right?
Yeah. Mm. And don't try and change everything at once, right?
Yeah.
Because if you say, okay, I'm not going to eat carbs and I'm going to train in the gym 5 times a week, I'm going to sleep early, I'm going to drink more water, it's too many fucking things, right?
Yeah.
You pick one thing and work on it, you know? That thing might be too hard for you, you might have to make it easier, you know? Mm. I mean, this is how I coach people. It's not like when people say, don't eat this, eat this, eat this. You can't just switch your whole life around in 2 minutes, right?
I remember 1 year ago, you talked about you want to design the people.
So, I've been here for what, 5 years now, 6 years? The main problem I see is that people don't make progress. To make progress, you have to record what you're doing because you have to be doing something a little bit better each time, otherwise you're not gonna grow, right? But I thought, how can I get people to write this stuff down? Because you can do any program in the world if you want, but if you write down and make sure you do a little bit heavy each time, you're gonna see results. Mm. Or you can do the best program in the world and don't write it down and you won't see any results. And it's that important. I know it sounds too simple and no one's talked about it so much yet, because but this is the gap I've seen between people doing well here and people not doing so well in their work now. Yeah.
Before, I might not really conscious of what's the weight I'm using and how many reps I do. I just do it, you know? When I received this book, okay, I told myself that I have to write down every sets I do and every weight I do. So when I'm doing that exercise, I really can recall, like, last time I do this exercise, what weight I use and what reps I use. When I found that, oh, I do 5 kilos more, and I will be like thrilled that I'm really progressing. And this happened on me, not from comparing to others, because this is the journey of mine. I can see what I'm accumulating and what I'm achieving. It's kind of just make me feel very happy. From I was young, I really like notebook stuff. I like things in my hand. To see, to touch, is very different from the digital stuff. The Facebook belongs to who, and you can write your information down. I noticed that there is a where I started and the measurements, so people can record down where they started, like the days, the weight, and the body fat percentage.
So it's simple, right? So every day you've got a new page. So you put your date, you check which day it is, what time you started, what time you finished. I mean, sometimes if you change how fast you do a workout, it's progress as well, right? You can put your weight if you want. Did you stretch? Did you warm up? And then you put all your exercise names in here. Your weights and reps and sets and your rest time. And how long you rested for if you're recording your rest times, right? Did you do any cardio? What type? Any notes here? And you can put how your workout is here.
I really like the part for you leaving the space that besides from the workout, you can also write some notes, like everything you wanted to write down, like what you eat for breakfast, and then how was your mood of today, or how is the workout like the emotions of you.
It's
also the same important as just doing a workout, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Man, I have a Christmas gift for you.
Thanks. What is it? Okay.
Yeah.
Cute, Ma.
3, 2, 1.
Merry Christmas!
那今天很谢谢 Matt 来参与我的访谈，让大家更知道要怎么设计自己的课表，跟如何在新的一年呢设定自己的目标。然后呢， Do you have any other words to say to the fans about the people?
So if you're not recording your stuff down, get one of these. It's going to make a difference, right?
Or
don't get one and continue what you're doing and not making any results. Simple.
12月的优惠组合，那第一个组合呢是这个豹纹串臀圈，然后以及 The Fitbook 健身笔记本，然后他们都是千元有找的组合。那接下来是新的这个 The Future is Female 的帆布袋， It's cute。然后呢，它里面有一个小的 pocket， 所以你可以放你的钱包啊、你的手机。对，其实就是一个很简单的袋子， 那因为我们健身或者是你去上学，就是都会需要放一些书啊，或者是放一些衣服，就女生的东西很多。那我觉得它的这个 size 刚刚好，然后因为它是比较厚的帆布，所以它也蛮耐重的，就是13寸的平板也可以放进去。然后这个新的帆布袋呢，也是限量，大概只有做200个，然后会跟 The Fit Book 也是另外一个优惠的组合。
I like it.
好啊，那就祝大家有一个美好的假期，我们下次再见喽，拜拜。
See you.